There is a new plugin called Roadmap WP. In this tutorial, I'm going to check out the free version and also buy the pro version. If you want to support me, follow this link to get the Roadmap plugin, wp.discount/roadmap. I will be forever grateful. Link is also in the comment section below. And then here we are at Roadmap WP, which is actually a brand new plugin, only been around for a couple of months. And I already really like the way the thing is built. Now, we have the free version and the pro version. We're going to start with the free version, and then I'm going to upgrade to the pro version so you know exactly if this is worth your money. Press on download now. And on here, we just click on this download button. Log into your WordPress website. If you're still using WP admin, that's not a very safe way. You need to secure your WordPress website because you really don't want to get hacked. Then we go over here to plugins, add new plugin. Then we press upload plugin. And we're going to select the plugin we've just downloaded. And then we press on install now. Activate plugin. And then we can see that we have a new post type called idea, and we see on the left side roadmap. Now let me walk you through setting up this roadmap and actually putting it on the front side of your website. Here we go, click on roadmap. And then we are at the new post type called ideas. Here we can add in ideas. We're going to do that in just a second. First we go to settings. In the settings we can allow comments on ideas. Could be very useful if people want to share their, wow, this is amazing, you should really build this, or I'm going to use this in this and this way, then it's actually pretty nice to read from your clients, customers, or audience. Then we have the default status term for new ideas, so it can be closed, maybe new idea, not now on roadmap, up next. But let's keep it on new idea as the logical thing. And then we have a couple of features which are only available in Pro, but I'm going to show you in just a minute. Then we press save changes and we go to taxonomies over here. Also, this one is only available for Pro. And then the last thing is the help page. This looks pretty straightforward. So let's start building our roadmap on our website. First, we're going to copy this new idea form. Click to copy it. Then we go to pages and I'm going to create a new page. First, going to add in a row over here. And we're going to add in a code module. Then I'm going to paste in a short code new idea form. Very simple. Then I'm going to duplicate this module. And then I'm going to use this display ideas over there. And I think I'm going to drag and drop this over there now. And then to show the ideas, we can use three different types. We have a grid filled with published ideas. We also have columns filled with ideas based on statuses. So these are the statuses. We can also display tabs, also based on statuses. Let's first add in a couple of ideas so I can show you how this all looks on the front end. So we go over here and we're going to submit new ideas. Dokkan Vendor Marketplace Tutorial. Something like this. And we're going to press on submit idea. Thank you for your submission. But also something like this. E-commerce website using Elementor Pro and WooCommerce. Submit the idea. Speed up websites with a free plugin. Now, when I now go to my roadmap ideas, I can see that we have a couple of new ideas. Now, if we want to publish them, we go to quick edit over there and we press on published. Press update. And that's also you can do in bulk. Just select them all. Press bulk action. Press edit. Apply. And then we can just change the status to published. Update them. And now you can see that we have three ideas which are all published. Now I want to change this idea to on the roadmap, update this status, and then we have a new idea on the roadmap and closed. Then I'm going to add in a short code to my website. I just use the code module from Divi. I'm just going to add in this one, the roadmap status, and I'm going to do it with new idea and on roadmap, and we also have a closed one. Let's see how this goes. Then we can see that we have new ideas on roadmap and closed. And of course you can style it even better because now we have a new ideas. We have two of them on the roadmap one and closed also one, and you can change it on here. But what you can also do of course is create different kind of sections yourself. Just go into this one, make it like two columns, and then you can change a little bit around with the colors on side of your website. So let's change this to new idea. And then I'm gonna copy this. then this entire module, I will copy it to this side. Then we can have, for example, new ideas over here. And then on here, I want to have this on road map, for example, like this. And now we have new ideas, and on the roadmap we have this ones. And we can of course add in some background color in here, so you can actually style it a little bit yourself, which is of course possible within your page builder, Divi or Elementor, or whatever you want to do with it. Now let's make it a little bit lighter. I'm going to upgrade to the pro version. Let's get back to roadmap WP and press on download. I'm going to buy this for my own website, press add to cart, go to checkout, just fill in all the information over here and pay with credit card, and then we press on purchase. And then you see this, we can download it over here, so click on this. And also let's make sure to copy this license, copy it, then go back to your WordPress website. In here I go to plugins, add new plugin. Then I'm going to upload the pro version and press install now. And then we press activate plugin. Excellent. What do I now see is two roadmaps. So I think I'm just going to disable the free version over here, roadmap, deactivate, and I'm going to delete it also. And if I now go to my settings, I can see that I can set publish, pending or draft. I'm going to put them all on publish, press save changes. So if you want to style this apart from your own page builder, we can go over here to the theme customizer. And then we can see on the left side, we can see roadmap styles. Here we go. We go to global styles. And then I can over here and change, for example, the photo button background color. Click on it. I mostly use this color on my website. So this is beautiful. The text color should be white. These are the text background color and text color. Submit idea button background color. Let's change it also to my dark blue color. And then we can also see here that the submit idea text color should be white then. Yeah, this is way better. Now we can actually read it. All right, and then we have the tabs. The tabs are actually really nice. What I would like to see is different kind of colors per tab. That would also be great. And also these buttons. Can I change the buttons of the tabs? Let's see, tab styles. Container background color is white. Text background color white, tab text color is this one. Okay, that looks great. I should now be able to change my background color in something completely different, and it should stay white. It actually does not, and I'm a bit disappointed about that one. So this plugin looks really promising on the functionality side. If you're a developer and you can change all the colors and all the layouts to perfectly fit in your own website, then this would really be a good plugin for you. However, to get really big for this plugin to support and help the masses out there with their WordPress websites, the developers really should work a little bit on styling and showing it on the front end. But I think this is all going to be fine. Now, another thing that should be fine is your SEO. Make sure to check out this tutorial of mine where I show you exactly what SEO plugin you'll be needing for your website.